Ciao a tutti and welcome to another video. So today we're gonna do another journal page on my bigger journal, and we are gonna use some watercolor as a background. It's gonna be a kind of quick and easy background, but then I'm gonna do a lot of doodle on this page. So on my palette I'm mixing two color. I'm mixing Pinace Gray and Coal Black. So I wanted to have a very dark blue background, and I don't mind about strokes visible. I really look for that. And then I took this page from magazine, and this will be our focal point. So I'm gonna cut everything, and I was not sure in the beginning if I wanted to cut the eyes as well, but in the end I decided to remove the central part. Then I'm trying to understand in which place I should position it. I decided to put everything on the right, and I'm now just tracing with a pencil where the image will be, so I can continue with the background and add my focal point in that triangle in the middle. So let's do the base of the watercolor as well on the left side, and again I don't mind if there is, you can see still a difference between the first layer and second layer. It doesn't matter, it's fine. I will put a lot of doodling on top. So now the focal point. So in that triangle I wanted to have a pop-up of colors, let's say. So we will have the gray, cloudy, I think you can think about cloudy sky, and in the middle, in the center, just a pop-up color. I'm using again some mixing color in my watercolor palette, and then try to do some doodling here and there. I'm not so precise with the brush, with the watercolor, that's in general. So I will do some, let's say, the big stroke with the watercolor palette, but then I will move the detail with my markers. It will help for sure. So here I will just speed it up everything, so you will just see the final product. Now, time to glue the magazine cutout to the page, so then we can complete, let's say, the focal point. It was pretty difficult to glue this one because there was that hole in the middle and the ends were a bit big, so, but okay, I think pretty much I managed. Even if I have some wrinkling due to the glue, I mean, it's fine, it's okay, it's my journal page. Now, other doodling. So this page, I think I did a lot of doodling. In real time, it took me 1 hour and 40 minutes, or even more, let's say. But with the magical editing power, you will see really in just 6 minutes. So I will speed it up also this process. I want to mention something about the Uniposca that I'm using for detail. So as you see, sometimes the Uniposca is not working well, and you need to push to have some color, more color out. Pay attention on that one, because if you do in the journal page, you may have a lot of color coming out, too much. That's why I'm doing on the side on another piece of paper, and then time to time I'm dabbing there and using again the color. In this way you can even reuse, don't waste, let's say, any things. That's a good tip. We'll be right back. always on my journal page cannot we cannot avoid to have a quote, at least in my journal. And so the quote of today is find a place inside yourself where nothing is impossible. I'm trying to do it in a modern calligraphy style, but again, it's not really my vibe yet. I'm not there. But I'm first drawing everything with a pencil and then going on top with the marker. So in this way, everything will come out much, much easier, at least for me. Then I will cut everything and then glue everything on top of my page. And basically that's the final page. So this is my place inside myself where nothing is impossible. It's basically my art journal. So that's the page. That's it for today. I leave some close-up picture in the end. And if you like it and you got inspired, just give me a thumbs up and leave me a comment below to let me know which is your nice place where everything is possible. Okay, thanks a lot for watching. See you soon. Bye bye.